Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to Teacher Lisa's English Classroom. I'm Lisa. Nice to see you here. Today, we are going to learn English with fun. And today, there is a before our lesson. Lisa see there is a secret guy who's a black man. He said, welcome to this. And let's see, do you know who he is? This guy have a brown head and a wrong hand. Do you know who he is? I think some of you are so smart, have know who it is, right? Yes, he is Doraemon. So today, Doraemon will join our English classroom and learn English with us today. So Doraemon is so happy that he can learn English with us. So he greet with us, say, "Hi, my name is Doraemon." Doraemon's so happy, and by the at the time, he also see there is a man with is yellow and wear glasses, and he also wear a bear doll. It's so similar. Do you know who he is? But Doraemon so he didn't know, so he asked him a question. What's your name? So, do you know who it is? Yes, it's me, and his name is Bob. So Minion is so happy to greet everyone and say, "Hi, my name is Bob." So Bob is so happy that he can learn English with us. And everyone, boys and girls, you can use your hand and wave to say, "Hello, Bob, nice to see you." And after that, Bob also sees someone coming. The person have the is white and the big ear and the tail. It looks like a dog. Do you know who he is? Minion didn't know, so he asked him the question, "What's your name?" And the one answered, "Hi, I'm Snoopy." Wow, it's Snoopy. Snoopy is so happy that he can be here. So the Snoopy smile happily and say, "I'm Snoopy." So everyone, let's wave our hand and say, "Hello, Snoopy." And after that, Snoopy also see there is a person waved at him and looking at him. This person with red eyebrow, big eyes, blue mouth, and red hands. Do you know who he is? Snoopy also asking the question, saying, "What's your name?" And the person answered, "Hello, I'm Forky." Yes, I think some of you have seen him in the Toy Story 4, right? He is Forky. So everyone, let's wave our hand and say, "Hello, Forky." Okay, Forky is so happy that he will stay here and learn English with us today. There is a person coming to the classroom, and the person have the black and yellow ear and have a long yellow tail. Do you know who it is? I think some of you have no answer. But Forky seems to didn't know. So he asked him a question, "What's your name?" And the answer, that's right, it's Pikachu. So Pikachu answered, "Hi, I'm Pikachu." And at the same time, Pikachu also see there is a girl coming. The girl with the long, big eyes and long curly hair. Do you know who she is? Pikachu didn't know. So he asked the girl, "What's your name?" And the girl answered, "Hi, I'm Nesco." Oh, the girl is Nesco. Nesco is so shy, but she want to meet everyone. So she wave her hand and say, "Hi, I'm Nesco." So of you can wave your hand and also say hello to Nesco. So this is our friend today. So today we have six friends will learn English with us today. So everyone, you can say, "Nice to meet you." So before we move on our lessons, we will know today's lessons. We are going to learn the sentence, "What's your name?" But you want to make friends. We can use this kind of sentence called "What's your name?" In Chinese, we say 你叫什么名字？当小朋友想要在认识别人，但是你却不知道该怎么称呼别人，不知道别人叫做什么名字的时候，可以选择使用这样的句子来询问对方，来认识对方。Let's try to read this sentence together. What's your name? Let's read one more time. What's your name? While you're writing, don't forget the question mark here.Ellie and Yo, 如果你在做书写这个句子的时候，它是问句，所以小朋友不要忘记啊，要在问句的后面加上 question mark 问号，才能呈现完整的句子哦。If someone asks you this kind of question, how do you answer? That's okay. Lisa will tell you how to answer this kind of question. The first one is that.The first way you can answer is, my name is. In Chinese, we say, 我的名字叫做。How you answer this kind of sentences, you can see the underline here. You can put on your English name or Chinese name, that will be okay. Or you can put on the name you want others to call you. 当别人问你 what's your name, 想认识你的时候，这时候呢，你可以选择第一种回答方式，叫做 My name is。好，底下的底线这个地方呢，小朋友可以放上你的英文名字。如果没有英文名字，小朋友可以使用中文名字，或者是你想要让让对方称呼你的方式都可以。Let's practice sentences together. My name is. Let's try one more time.My name is. Now, let's welcome Doraemon to practice this sentence with us together. If Doraemon, he would answer, My name is Doraemon. And while Doraemon is writing, don't forget to put period at the end of the sentences.这里还要再次提醒小朋友，这个句子是指数句。当小朋友使用书写的方式在写这样的句子的时候，不要忘记句子最后要记得点上句点。中文呢，我们就可以把这个句子翻成我的名字叫做哆啦 A 梦。And now, Lisa, I'd like to tell you the second way you can answer is I am.In Chinese, we say 我叫做。另外第二种方式呢，你可以怎么回答别人呢？就叫做 I am. Let's practice together. Say I am. Let's see one more time. I am. Now, let's welcome Forky to practice a sentence with this. Forky would say I am Forky. Let's try one more time. I am Forky. In Chinese, we say 我叫做查奇。Now, Lisa, I'd like to tell you the third way you can answer this kind of question. The third way is like I am. You can put I and am together and abbreviate them into I'm, one word.And in Chinese, we also call it 我叫做。第三种回答方式呢，小朋友可以把 I 跟 am 这两个字缩写合并变成一个字，变成 I'm。那小朋友可以看到 I 跟 am 中间这个字有一个缩写符号。In English, we call it apostrophe. Apostrophe.在英文呢，我们称缩写符号叫做 apostrophe。所以下次啊，小朋友如果在英文句子里面呢，看到呢有这个缩写符号，很有可能呢，这个字是经过怎么样缩写过的，不是它原本的样子哦。Now, last time, let's practice one more time. Say, I'm. Let's practice one more time. I'm.Now, let's welcome Pikachu to practice this sentence with this. Pikachu would say, "I'm Pikachu." And don't forget a period at the end. In Chinese, we call it 我叫做 Pikachu. Now, if all of your friends introduce their name, and you can answer "Nice to meet you." In Chinese, we say 很高兴认识你. 当对方都认识了彼此的名字之后呢，有一个很礼貌的回应方式可以结束话题，叫做 "Nice to meet you"，很高兴认识你。好，Let's practice to read the sentence together. Nice to meet you. Let's try one more time. Nice to meet you. And don't forget, at the end of the sentence, put on the period. And now let's welcome Mian to practice the sentence with us. 好，现在呢，我们来邀请呢 Mian 来跟我们一起练习一下今天的对话。今天呢，Lisa 遇到了 Mian，Lisa 可以先开心的介绍我自己，再问问对方的名字。Lisa 可以说 "Hi, my name is Lisa. What's your name?" 这时候 Mian 可以回答 "My name is Bob."接着，Lisa 可以很开心的跟 Bob 说 "Nice to meet you."那 Bob 当然也可以回答 Lisa："Nice to meet you too."这地方呢，小朋友会看到 Bob 在 "Nice to meet you" 后面多加了 "to" 这个字，它意思呢就是表达他也很开心可以遇见 Lisa 的意思，所以小朋友也可以这么回答哦。接下来 is our review time。Now, Lisa would like to welcome Snoopy to review with us. 接下来呢，Lisa 跟 Snoopy 一起来跟大家复习一下今天上课的内容，小朋友是不是都清楚了呢？如果今天呢，Lisa 遇到了 Snoopy，先跟 Snoopy 介绍我自己，然后我们再问 Snoopy，What's your name？那 Snoopy 该怎么回答呢？Snoopy will answer，A. I am three. B. My name is Newbie. C, nice to meet you. 聪明的小朋友，你肯定知道答案了。But don't worry, just hold on. 好，不要紧张哦。待会呢，Let's count down 3 seconds and let's show the answer together. 好，选好自己的答案。Let's count down 3 seconds. Three, two, one. The answer is B. My name is Snoopy，因为 Lisa 问的是 "What's your name？" 问的是你的名字，所以 Snoopy 应该合适的回答方式是告诉我他的名字，所以回答的是 "My name is Snoopy."小朋友都答对了吗？接着还有下一个挑战哦。接下来 Lisa 邀请了 Nezuko 来跟我们一起练习。Lisa say "Hi，my name is Lisa，What's your name？" 这时候 Nezuko 该怎么回答呢？Nesco 可有三种回答方式哦。The first one is bra 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 Nesco。The second one is bra bra Nesco。The third way is bra Nesco。聪明的小朋友可以动动脑，想想看，今天的课程 Lisa 教了大家三种回答 "What's your name" 的方式，小朋友可以想想看，教教 Nesco 可以该怎么回答呢？心里想想看哦，我们可以倒数3秒钟，待会，let's show the answer together. Three, two, one. Oh, you got the right answer? 你们都想到正确答案了吗？第一个回答，Nesco 可以很直接的回答说，My name is Nesco。我的名字叫做米豆子。My name is Nesco。这是第一种回答方式。当然，第二种回答方式呢，我们可以把 "My name is" 换成 "I am"。所以呢，第二种 Nesco 可以回答的方式叫做 "I am Nesco"。"I am Nesco" 意思也就是我叫做米豆子。那第三种方式呢，相信小朋友应该也很容易回答，对不对？可以把 "I" 跟 "am" 这两个字怎么样啊？Combine together 缩写 abbreviate these two words into I'm，把这 I 跟 am 两个字缩写之后呢，去掉 a，中间变成一个缩写符号，变成 I'm。 这个字呢，有些小朋友可能比较难念。那小朋友可以掌握的技巧呢，就是先把 I 念出来，最后的 M 可选择闭嘴巴的方式。这样就可以慢慢练习起来。先从慢慢念，再逐渐的速度加快。我们再练习一次，I'm。Very good. So the third way Nezuko can answer is I'm Nezuko. 在课程的最后呢，Lisa 提供的 two way 两个有趣的学英文的方式，可以给大家在课后多复习今天的课程哦。左边红色框框呢，小朋友可以利用手边的手机或者是平板来扫描这个 QR code，可以跟着一起在唱唱关于 What's Your Name 的歌。希望呢，Lisa 相信呢，在唱过 What's Your Name 的互动歌曲，小朋友呢肯定会对这样的句型会更清楚。接着，小朋友可以看到右边紫色框框呢，是关于 Dream Kid 这个游戏。Lisa 在里头呢设计了 What's Your Name 几个有趣的游戏跟句型，那同时也可以复习今天上课的内容。小朋友可以透过手边的手机或平板扫描，可以进去看游戏画面，相信小朋友会玩得很开心哦。至于该怎么使用、该怎么玩 What's Your Name 的 game 呢？好，这里呢，小朋友用手机扫描 QR code 进去呢，就会看到这个页面。那这个页面上面呢，虽然大部分的界面都是英文，但是小朋友应该不难懂。这里有一个框框，上面写 Your Name，这里呢，小朋友就要打上自己的英文名字。And then 底下呢有一个按钮 Join，Join 就是要加入，所以小朋友输入上次的英文名字之后呢，就可以点选 Join 加入。点选之后呢，小朋友就可以看到这个问题的框框，What's your name? Earn 10,000 to complete this assignment。好，这是这个游戏的主题，What's your name？目标呢，就是要小朋友呢要赚到1000块钱才能达成这次的作业目标。好，小朋友如果准备好要挑战的呢，就可以点选下面的蓝色按钮，Got it，我知道了。那小朋友点选进来呢，就可以回答
My
问
name
题。
is Phoebe. My name is Phoebe.
好，虽然声音有点小声哦，但是呢，小朋友如果用手机播放的时候，就可以调控音量的按钮。好，他解说 My name is Phoebe，所以小朋友可以听到这个句子，就可以知道 The answer is a green button, right? So you click the green button and you can get $1. 好，这时候小朋友就赚到1块钱了。那小朋友呢，赚到1块钱之后呢，可以选择按下面的 Continue，继续回答问题，继续赚钱。那赚的钱呢，小朋友就可以看上面的题号。第一题可以得，接下来再回答一题可以得到2块钱，再回答第二题就可以得到3块钱，以此类推。那赚到钱可以做什么呢？小朋友可以到 shop 这个地方呢，这有总共有四个技能，小朋友可以增强自己达到任务的速度跟能力，就从这个地方用自己赚的钱钱买。然后呢，如果现在钱钱不够钱，没办法买的时候，小朋友可以点选任何一个，他就会说：“哎，你要买这个技能的时候，就可以点 buy for $10。”但现在呢，哎，钱钱不够，没办法，所以小朋友呢，只能回到按这三条线，回到 question 这个地方，继续回答 question 来赚钱钱。好，所以呢，相信这个问题呢是复习也蛮好玩的，然后也难不倒小朋友。Lisa 期待最快能够赚到钱的，赚到1000块钱完成任务的小朋友哦。If you don't have any question of today's lesson, Lisa hope you like today's English lessons. If you don't have any problem, see you next time. Hope you have English and love English. See you.